Hey everybody, Ryan here, and I just want to talk about my Legacy Merfolk deck. This is a mono blue deck for Magic, and this was my start. It's not done. I think I got my sorceries down. I don't have all my creatures, of course, but let's go through it and see what I got. So, I got my true name Nemesis. I got three of them here. I'm missing one. I have the deck, I just haven't cracked it open. So those are definitely going to go in. Got my Master of the Pearl Trident because it gives all my Merfolk Island Walk and +1/+1. That's gonna go in. Missing Merfolk Lord of Atlantis. Are definitely missing from this deck. Also missing from this deck are all my islands. So the idea behind this deck is to keep the mana cost low. So I believe the converted mana cost, as I've put it together, is probably about 2. Next card I have Judge's Familiar, because it is a flying counterspell, which is awesome. This card is so underrated in every format that it's legal in, modern, vintage, legacy. I mean, it's a 1/1 flyer that you use white or blue. I had this in my modern mono white hate bears. Now it's in my vintage, my legacy blue merfolk, so that's going in there. Of course, I'm only going to run 2 of these. I only have 2. Got my Eternal Masters, and I got my from the Vault 20. So I'm only going to run 2 of these. It'd be stupid not to include Jace in a mono blue deck. So Jace is in there. Next, here are my spells. Swan Song. Got 2 of these. Don't like giving a flyer to my opponent. But enchantment, instant, and sorcery at instant speed for 1, that's pretty good. So that's the first one. Next, Force Spike, got 4 of those. Probably good early in the game if the opponent doesn't have mana. Got 2 Preordains. That guy could have more, but just went with 2. The rebuff. So it did, you know, cancels it's 2. Cancels, basically counter spell. Unless the controller plays X, where X is my devotion to blue. I like the devotion mechanic, so I have 4 of these in here. And it's only an uncommon. Vapor Snag. Get rid of a creature. It's returned to its control owner's hand. Controller loses 1 life. So you're gonna ping them for 1, and they're slowed down a little, and they've spent mana to cast their creature, so I like the spells in the deck. Next, I got my Delvers. I mean, 1 drop. It's dumb not to do it. I mean, it's flying 3/2. So definitely put that in there. And then, got my Lotus Petals for ramp. And then 2 Ghost Quarters. And then the rest are going to be, what are those things? Islands. For lands. So that was the start of my my legacy mono blue deck. It needs more merfolk. I don't have the complete deck list with me, but this is my attempt at a budget build. Let's put these over there. At a budget build. It's not quite for everybody to see, because legacy, vintage, all that stuff is expensive, and you want to play. I'm playing with what I got. This is stuff I've pulled from packs, except for the Lotus Petals. But for the most part, and the Delvers. So most of this I pulled from packs, and it was cheap. I mean, these are less than $1 a card at the time when I got them. So that's my methodology and thought process on this. So That's how I build the decks, and that's the way I my thought process. Because if you're gonna play something, play what you got and build around the theme. I love themes. So anyway, let me know what you think. Like, subscribe, on all that good stuff. Appreciate it. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye.